Let's add two Poisson random variables. It would show up on the test. I'm not ruling it out, I guess. Poisson is discrete, right? X, let's assume X is Poisson. What did Poisson variable, what were they about? They were in chapter three. It's a discrete random variable that counts the number of occurrences of something over some time interval or in some region, some area, or maybe some volume. A common kind of example would be in, say, an insurance application is to count the number of earthquakes of a certain magnitude in, say, Los Angeles over every decade or something like that. Maybe how many earthquakes are there somewhere in Los Angeles of magnitude, I don't know, 4.0 or greater every decade? I imagine there's at least one, maybe two. That kind of situation where you make a count of how many of those things occur over a certain amount of time is an example where people commonly try to use a Poisson random variable to do the counting and to do the modeling. So it's a very well-used kind of distribution. Let's assume X is Poisson with mean two. That's the thing that's called K in the book, or lambda times S. You had some homework problems where you were using Poissons recently, so you had to look it up. S is typically taken to be the, well, you got a certain unit of time, for example, maybe a year, maybe 10 years or something. And S counts the number of those time periods, and lambda is the number of occurrences per time period. If you were focused on S being counting the number of years, and then your ultimate focus is on the number of earthquakes per decade, then lambda would be the number of earthquakes on average per year, and then S would be 10 years in a decade. And then K would be the average number of earthquakes per decade. Okay, don't worry about it. That's just a reminder. And let's say Y is Poisson of mean three. That's also K for that random variable. And let's probably make more sense to call it S, but I'm going to go ahead and call it W again. Let W be the sum of X and Y. And we'll make our usual assumption that X and Y are independent. By the way, I should have emphasized that I also, in the previous problem, could have found the means of X and Y and W. And yes, it is true that the expected value, the mean of W, is the mean of X plus the mean of Y. And that's something you've always known since you ever learned chapter three in Prob and Stats. And it is true, and you can confirm it with the formulas here. But what I want you to realize is this fact, even though it's a fundamental fact that we always use, because it ultimately refers to convolutions, is not so easy to prove, actually. Even though you've used that all the time in Prob and Stats and this course whenever you needed it, it's actually not so easy to prove. Not easy, as easy as you might hope, because the distribution of the sum is difficult to deal with. Even when you assume X and Y are independent, you still have to do this convolution idea. So it's still a difficult thing to think about. I do want to relate this to chapter seven here still today, but hang on. So W is X plus Y. Here's our question. What is the distribution of W? What kind of random variable is it? We will address that with chapter seven ideas more simply using the moment generating function. But for the moment, let's think about it in terms of this new idea, this discrete convolution. And let's go ahead and think about it in the more general formula. Poisson random variables are non-negative They don't take on negative values. And therefore, I can think of the formula this way. When your random variable takes on negative values, then you have to allow for k starting at perhaps some negative value or maybe even negative infinity when you look at the summation. Yikes. But since our random variable starts with, our random variables only had to take on negative values with positive probability, we can do a simpler version. So h of w, just like before, is going to be the PMF, probability mass function, for w. It is this probability. I should use a cursive w to emphasize its lowercase here. And because of independence, that allows me to say, ultimately, that this is a summation of products of the PMFs of x and y. Same kind of summation that was on the other page. K goes from 0 to w of f of w minus k times g of k, where f and g are the PMFs of x and y. PMF of x, PMF of y. Okay, so I guess I need to remind myself the PMF of a Poisson random variable. You can look in the chapter 3 table for that. Right there. E to the negative k times k to the x over x factorial, where k is the mean. It's also the variance. That's a not a typical property for the variance and the mean to be equal, but it is for Poissons. So here's that. Here with x, it's with k equal to 2, and with y, k is 3. For x, k equals 2, so I get the value of little f is e to the negative 2. 2 to the x, but I'm plugging w minus k in for x. So it's really 2 to the w minus k. Ugh. I guess I'm not making my w cursive here. Oh, well. Over w minus k factorial. That's the x factorial. And the g is k is 3, e to the negative 3. Times 3 to the k over k factorial. Wow, this doesn't look so easy. But it is doable if you're good enough at algebra, which I wasn't sure I was going to be before I worked on this morning, but then I figured it out. We want to simplify this thing. Doesn't look like it could be simplified, but it actually can. It can be simplified pretty far, actually. One thing you can do is you can factor out, you can combine the e to the negative 2 and the e to the negative 3 to get e to the negative 5. And that can be pulled in front of the summation. It's a constant. And thinking about doing that reminds me, maybe we might be hoping something's true. We might be praying that maybe W is Poisson. And maybe its mean is 2 plus 3, 5. I mean, insurance companies have to think about this. If X is the number of earthquakes in a decade in Los Angeles and Y is the number of earthquakes in a decade in San Francisco, the sum is the number of earthquakes per decade in Los Angeles or San Francisco combined. If we're modeling X and Y as Poisson, it'd sure be nice if their sum is Poisson, and that'd be nice and simple, and maybe it's true, at least if you assume independence. And the answer is, yes, it actually is true. We will get that. It'll be a Poisson random variable with a mean of 5. So that gives me hope in seeing e to the negative 5. the final answer has got to involve e to the negative 5, and there it is. Well, what do you do with all the rest of the stuff? Once again, I'm kind of hoping that the answer is a Poisson with a mean of 5. What would the PMF of a Poisson with a mean of 5 be? I'm hoping I can simplify it to this thing when k is 5. I've already got the e to the negative 5. I'd have to get a 5 to the x and or 5 to the w and then divide by w factorial. But what about the summation? What's going to happen here? I got the e to the negative 5. Okay, in my quest to realize this hope that this is going to be Poisson, maybe I should try to get a w factorial on the bottom somehow. Because I'd have to have a w factorial at the end there. Wow. My denominator is this, which does not equal, the product of those two things does not equal w factorial. But I could make this thing become a w factorial if I just multiply the top by the appropriate thing. And I'm realizing I don't have enough space. I could make this be a w factorial on the bottom. How? By multiplying this fraction by an appropriate form of 1. What's the appropriate form of 1? Put the 2 to the w minus k here. The appropriate form of 1 would be w times w minus 1 times w minus 2 dot, dot, dot times w minus k plus 1 over that same product, which I've already included by writing w factorials. Let's move the w factorial over here more so it's more symmetric. The e to the negative 5 on front comes from the e to the negative 2 and the e to the negative 3. Pull that out in front. It's no longer there. I'm focused on this fraction equaling this fraction. Because to get from here to here, I multiplied by this guy's form of 1. This entire product divided by that same product, which I combine with the w minus k factorial to say it's w factorial. Don't forget about everything else over here as well. Well, I already factor out the e to the negative 3. This over here is just 3 to the k over k factorial. So that's progress, perhaps, because I got a w factorial down there like I'm hoping I can get. And in fact, it's even more progress. W factorial doesn't depend on k. I can factor it out. I'm feeling good. It can be factored out of the summation on the bottom because it doesn't depend on k. W is fixed. K is the variable here in the summation. What am I left with? I can't. Well, I could factor out individual things here, but I don't want to factor it out anything individually here. I mean, the end result of all these products does depend on K. Leave those in there. Put this all over K factorial. And then write 2 to the w minus k here and 3 to the k there. Does anybody feel like they know where I'm going with this? Anybody feel, have an gut instinct as to what fundamental fact that you have learned about in the past that I'm going to use here to simplify this a lot? Binomial theorem. This thing right here is W choose K. It may not look like it because you think of W choose K as W factorial divided by K factorial times W minus K factorial. But those are the same thing. Because W factorial is the same as all this stuff on the top times W minus K factorial, and the W minus K factorials can cancel. E to the negative 5 over W factorial times the summation K goes from 0 to W of W choose K times 2 to the W minus K times 3 to the K. I just realized I probably shouldn't have used K as my index of summation because I already used K as the mean of the Poisson. Sorry about that. Up here, K is mean of Poisson. Down here, K is index of summation. The binomial theorem allows us to simplify that summation greatly to 2 plus 3 to the W power. That's the binomial theorem. Right? Usually, you know, 2 and B are letters like A and B or something, or P and Q. But here they're actual numbers. And there we have it. Isn't this beautiful? It's simplified to the PDF of a Poisson with mean 5. And this is valid for W equals 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. If you add a Poisson with mean K1 to a Poisson with mean K2 and they're independent Poissons, the result will be a Poisson whose mean is K1 plus K2. K1 is 2 here, K2 is 3.